Welcome to the next segment of our micro-learning program on healthcare quality improvement basics. This program is based on the model for improvement recommended by the Institute for Healthcare Improvement. This segment will focus on how to use SMARTIE goals to support your quality improvement efforts. SMARTIE goals will help your team establish your quality improvement aim and also be used when planning your PDSA cycle and implementing and monitoring your changes over time. Now, a little more on this topic, provided as part of the PATH QAPI Basics series.
All improvement requires setting an aim that defines what you're trying to accomplish and by when. It is best to make sure that we are smart with our aims. A smart aim or goal is specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and timely. Let's break down the components that make an aim smart. First, the S, specific. By getting specific, you will clearly define exactly what needs to be done. When creating a specific aim, try to answer the 5 W questions. What do we want to accomplish? Why is this important? Who is involved or who is this intended to help? Where will this take place? Which resources or limits are involved? M is measurable. It is important to have measurable aims so that you can track your progress and know if and when you have achieved your aim. A measurable goal should address questions such as how much, how many, how will we know when we're done? It can also be very motivating to see that progress is being made. Measuring and monitoring goals periodically can reaffirm that all effort is making a difference and encourages people to keep working towards the aim. A is for achievable or attainable. To be realistic, a goal must be something that you are both willing and able to do. It's important to honestly evaluate your team's abilities and scope. Key questions to address here are, how realistic is it to accomplish based on other constraints? What is in our scope and power to change? How can we engage the support or involvement of others to make this more realistic and achievable? It is important to note an aim can be both difficult and realistic, so don't be afraid to aim high. A high aim can actually be easier to reach than a low one because a low aim exerts low motivational force. Consider goals that challenge and stretch your team without setting yourselves up for imminent failure. One of the best ways to make an achievable aim is to break a large aim down into smaller goals. R stands for relevant. This step is about ensuring that the aim actually matters to you and your team and that it aligns with other strategic plans and goals. A relevant goal can answer yes to these questions. Does this seem worthwhile? Does this support our strategic plan? Are we the right team for this? Lastly, T, timely and time-bound. Here we address a 6 W, when. We first ask, is this the right time for this aim and project? Or in other words, do we have enough capacity to give this aim the attention it needs and deserves? Then we set specific time boundaries for the effort. Without an end date, there is no sense of urgency, no reason to take any action today. Without making an aim time-bound, it can be ignored and placed on the back burner indefinitely. Having the specific time frame and ensuring the team is held accountable to that time frame drives the necessary motivation to accomplish the aim. Aims with small, incremental changes may benefit from daily or weekly time frames, whereas larger projects or organizational strategic plan aims may require several months or even years. A time-bound aim answers, how long will it take to reach this aim? What can we do today, 6 weeks from now, 6 months from now? As you begin improvement projects, it is important to define what you want to achieve and be smart with your aim.
To help ensure inclusion and health equity, SMART goals have evolved into SMARTIE goals. Inclusion and equity are part of a SMARTIE goal framework, which should be used when establishing your quality improvement aim. They will help you look at your quality improvement efforts through a health equity lens. Inclusion means, have you invited, considered, and incorporated input from the population of focus? And equitable means, does the objective address the unique needs and circumstances of different populations? Asking this question throughout the process will help your team ensure inclusion and equity are embedded in your quality improvement efforts. The next segment covers how to use data to support your quality improvement efforts.